the walls of Punahou's Heinrich Fitness Center features the names of Punahou students who have set records in various athletic benchmarks, such as pull-ups, jump rope, vertical leap, and the like. Punavision takes a look at the training and preparation that goes into making an attempt at these marks.
I first found out about that, the Punahou athletic records when I was in ninth grade. I basically was working out in the weight room, and then I looked up at the board, and then I asked Coach Troy about the records, or about what it was and how you could get your name up on the board. And then I kind of just looked at which record I would be able to break, and then, or I thought I could be able to break, and then when I saw the jump rope, and I thought I'd give it a try. I've been kind of busy recently, like with senior year, so I try to practice every time I come to the weight room to do like workouts for tennis. I spend the first like 5 to 10 minutes like just practicing jump rope and doing like a bunch of different stuff, like, or going as fast as I can, and then doing like one foot or like on the other foot and like double jumps and stuff. So I just practice a little bit like each time I come to the weight room, and then before I break it, I'll just try and practice every day, and then I think that's how I practice a lot.
The board was prior to my coming in. When I took over as head trainer here, I had asked VPC to actually redo the board, and it's now called Poons That Rock. And ever since then, we've had people start to break records, and every year at the end of the school year, people try to go for something that's on the board there that they think they can challenge themselves to try and break. And honestly, almost every year, we have at least two or three people that break one of the old records of 20 years old or whatever it may be. Well, I mean, obviously, there's things on that board that don't necessarily have to be lifting in here. Like, for instance, there's a jump rope record. It doesn't mean that they can't come in here, and they may not like the bench press or squat. So this gives those students opportunities also to want to try and do something else here and be recognized. It's up to them. I'm not going to tell these kids, you know, there's records there to break all the time. They have to have their self-motivation to come in and train for it. I will help them. How can you improve your pull-ups? I'll tell them how they can improve their pull-ups. Or how can I increase my vertical jump? I can give them workouts for their legs to help increase that. So yes, I can help them if they're dedicated enough. If they never come in, I can't help them. So if they come in, hey, I'm here for you. So it's up to them. They have to take that first step. When I have PE during the year, I have 7th grade PE, 8th, and all the way to 9th in academy. They see that when they're in here working out, and they're like, ooh, I think I can beat that record, or ooh, I want to try that. And they see that, and yeah, it gives them a little incentive maybe to start coming in here. That's all I need. I need somebody who wants it. And maybe they don't get the record, but at least they're working out. And, you know, that's going to make them a stronger athlete down the road.